Na-late lang noon ko, pasensya.
Time check is 7:17.
Ano, sir?
Ay, na po. Sige, click mo yung slide from the beginning. Yeah. Okay. Good luck, Joseph. You may now start your presentation.
So, good evening, guys. This is my report. It's all about data types. Comments are denoted by a slash for a single line of a block of a statements to comment, and asterisk slash you want to comment for e.g. slash single line in comment, slash asterisk to comment a paragraph of a statement that you do not want the system to run. Understanding C data types. As the name suggests, a data type defines the type of data being used. Whenever we define a variable or use any data language program, we have to specify the type of the data so that the compiler knows what type of data to expect. C data types, broadly, there are 5 different categories of data types in the C language. They are type, basic, example, character, integer, floating, point, double, derived, array, structure, union, enumerations, or enums, bool type, true or false, void, empty value. C primary data types. The language has 5 basic primary or primitive data types. They are number 1, character, ASCII, character set, or generally a single alphabet or AB, etc. 2, integer used to share whole numbers like 1 to 100 or 1000, floating point, decimal point, or really numbers, values 99.9 or 10.5. Double, very large numeric values which are not allowed integer or floating point type. Void, this means no value. This data type is mostly when defined functions. Data type or keyword character are integer, int, floating point, float, double, void, or void. C data type modifiers. In the C language, there are 4 data types modifiers that are used along with the basic data types to categorize them further. Similarly, there are modifiers in the C language to make the primary data types more specific. Following are minus, sign, unsigned, long, short. That's the end of my report. Thank you.
Sir? Balik tayo sa first slide, Joseph. Yung sa comments, we just need to clarify things out regarding the comments. Again, tama ito. Double backslash are the notes. Okay, ito yung ginagamit natin used to insert comments, right? Yung ito lang, yung sa second line, ito siya, kasi the correct way to use a multi-line or it's the koan, kumbaga one or more lines yung gagamitin na comment. Kasi may missing po dito sa second, parang nag-rumble niya siya. Second and third line of the definitions of comment. Kasi the correct way to insert comment is ito siya, nasa huli. As a backslash asterisk and asterisk backslash, nakafollow po kayo. And I know you are all aware and familiar with comments, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, again, we have 2 ways to insert comments. Ito po, single line comment, ito siya. Then, the comment, so comment a paragraph or of statement that you do not want the system to run. Ito siya. So again, how we have 2 ways to insert comment. Yung double backslash, ibig sabihin po nito, 1 line lang po yung comments na malalagay natin inside our source code, our program. The second one, if gusto natin 1 or more, it would be 3 line comments po ang insert natin. We just need to insert backslash asterisk. Ito po na sa ano. Nakapalong po kayo. Backslash asterisk. And kailangan ang pair niya po is asterisk backslash. So that is the koan. Mga paragraph or one or more line po. The next one is, sige, next pair is Joseph. Eto siya. Sa data types, meron tayong, paki-next to Joseph. Nabasa naman yan sa kanina. So we have five different, eto siya ang interesting about your presentation about Mr. Maspinas kasi very detailed siya in a way that may mga kontra na advanced na data types na present. Especially the data type void. Kasi most of the time, especially for the beginners, hindi pa talaga siya pinapresent si void. Kasi light confusing si void. Kasi when I talk about basic program, the fundamentals, kumbaga first, kung ano na niya, hindi pa siya kayo sa ma-emphasize or ma-stress out si void. Si void are kuan ka ng, most common na siya si void when you talk about function. Okay, functions that does not return a value. So void ang ginagamit sa na data type for that. Can you next press? These are the data types, guys. So, we have five. Tama yung naman.
Ang mama, sir.
Kasi pag-mute na lang po, Mr. Joseph. Okay. Again, tama po ito. We have five data types. Yung mga na-present ko lang po before, yung sa mga basic. Kasi nga, mute na lang tayo dito sa mute. Okay. Again, we have five data types, guys. No, namely, basic. So, ito yung sa mga basic data types. And usual, ito yung mga ginagamit natin inside our program. So, for characters, we will be using char. For integer, we'll be using int. For floating points or numbers with decimal values, so we have two, float and double. Ang difference lang ng float at double, back tayo Joseph. Okay, the difference between float and double, guys, is that si float is, ito yung nag-hold ng konti lang na value. Pag when you talk about double, doubles, from the word itself, double the size of floating. Still, floating points po ang ino-hold ng double. It means, numbers with decimal value ito, the same with float. Kaya lang, pag sinabi natin double, it's twice the capacity of float. Naka-follow?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sandali ha.
Ba't ba siya kukul, ha?
Hello, is my audio visible now? Audible na ba?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, again, going back to the discussion, you know, wala ka ng content. Again, these are the basic data types, guys. We have char or character, integer, float or floating, for floating points or numbers with decimal values, and doubles also. So again, kay double, it's the twice the capacity of float. Okay, but most common na sa ginagamit natin, the character, the integer, and the float po. Yan po ang mga tatlo. Sa basic kasi si double hindi naman siya masyadong ginagamit kasi we have float already for floating points and numbers with decimal value. Now, other type or other data type is what we call derived. Derived means we have array, structure, and union. We have three. So, wala to na siya. Madiscuss natin si array during the finals, I think. Structure and union, common siya kay kanang data structure, from the word structure. Okay, data structures po. May, kanta lang kayo, may separate subject kayo for this. Next is sa enumeration. Enumeration, short for enum. Okay, enumeration na siya. Example, anang fun is, maybe in the future po, we're going to have enum, but,
report na mo ba?
Hindi siya common na makita na ito.
Okay na, calls?
Parang siya kailan na ito sa ma-encounter si enum. Bool type or boolean number of boolean type of data type, boolean data type guys, that accepts only true or false value. Okay? Ang gina-accept lang niya is true or false. Sana lang sa short. Ito po yung sabi ko kanina na other data type guys is what we call void. And ang ibig sabihin po niyan is empty value. So, pag sinabi natin empty values, wala siyang kuan. But, medyo maaga pa siya to discuss void kasi more on, ma-discuss natin ito kasama ng array during the finals, guys. Kasi, kung pag sinabi natin void, hindi talaga siya natin magamit inside the main function. Kasi, ito yung gamit ng function, guys. Function, we have sa function kasi, just an overview kasi na-presenta natin si void. Functions, guys, we have two types of functions. Functions that returns a value and functions that does not return a value. Pag sinabi natin function that returns a value, dito po lalabas si integer and data type, character and float and also double. Pag function that does not return a value, dito po lalabas si void. Kaya nga, di ba, empty value. Pero, you can display. We can use a void to display. Kasi hindi nga siya naga-return of value. In short, empty po. So, ganyan siya. Again, we'll be ma-encounter natin si void na data type, guys, during the final. Kasama po si array. Okay, that is just an overview. Okay, move tayo, Mr. Joseph, sa next. So, eto. Okay, eto na nga yung sabi ko kanina. Hindi lang na-stress out si character. Now, this is what you call ASCII. Pag sinabi natin ASCII, ASCII is short for American Standard Code Information Interchange. Familiar with ASCII table?
Oh!
Okay. For ASCII table, guys, may table yan sa equivalent ng decimal value to the alphabet. Sa alphabet. So, small letter A again, yan is for programming, different po ang meaning ng small letter A at capital letter A. Okay? For integers, ito po, use to store whole numbers from 1. Ito siya, correct yung term, like 1. Kasi pag sinabi natin from 1, ito yung kung the range. Kasi pag sinabi natin integer, it holds also negative value aside from the positive. Okay? For floating points, number, ito siya, decimal point or real numbers, value like 99.9. Ito yung nga, meron siyang decimal value. Ito yung sabi ko kanina, si number 4 kay double. Double very large numeric values which are not allowed in integer and floating point. Si double, hindi talaga siya po sa integer. Pero more on, ito siya, mas dali siya man nato ma-identify ang difference ni double of the float when it comes to, kasi both double and float, guys, hold values with decimal point or decimal value. Ang difference lang, again, yung sinabi ko nga, si float, ito kaya lang siya, kanang, ang si, in short, si float, ito yung, for example, yung mga, kaya lang siya, kaya niya, ingunan na range. Meron siya. So, that is an, kaya na lang sa inyo, ha. Pag double, again, it is twice the capacity of float. Yung hindi kaya ng range ni float, kaya yan ni double kasi mas malaki yung capacity ni flow, double again compared kay flow. Ito yung number 5. Ito yung sabi, this means no value. This data type is mostly used when we, ayun nga, di ba? Ang sabi ko, function kasama ng array. Define function and again, kasama ito ng array na i-discuss natin during definer. Next tayo, Joseph. Okay. Ito yung mga keywords at the equivalent data type. So, sa character, we will be using car. So, I know you're familiar or common sa na word na car. Before, siguro yung sa generation namin, dili po siya katong nakuha na ka na yung expression na car. Sana siya. So, this is not readable as char, ha? Car na siya. Kasi short for character. The other keyword is int or most common siya sa word na kumbaga, pronounce siya as int. Short for integer. Kung may integer, mag-whole na siya whole numbers or number na walay decimal point. Pag nabi natin floating point, dito na malalabas si float. Float kasi double. Yun nga na-mention ko kanina. For void, obviously, void talaga yung keyword ng ating file na gagamitin. Again, for void, guys, this is something to do with functions. Ma-encounter natin siya during definer. Next, Joseph. For data types modifiers na sinasabi dito, we have similarities that are modifiers in C language or C++ actually. Kasi C and C++ ay kwala lang siya. Duha na siya ka programming, actually, duha ka programming language, but then again, nalang siya yung mga differences. Kasi nga, si C++ is a direct kwan siya ka ng the updated, the modified version of C. Okay, but different po yung mga koan ka ng developer. But common na lang siya. Next is Joseph. So, ito siya, following modifiers, guys, kumbaga, from the basic or from the usual na data type na ginagamit natin, we can modify or we can upgrade by adding this keyword. Signed, kumbaga pwede nyo gamitin signed int A, pwede yan siya. Unsigned int A, pwede yan. We'll be having also long and short. So, apat yan siya na modifier. Next, Joseph. And thank you yung nakalagay, binasa ko lang. Question?
Before
that, thank you, Mr. Joseph. Yes, Mr. Koan.
Okay na, salamat.
Thank you. Walang tanong? Is there any
question, sir?
Ah, okay. Before I talk my question tayo from Mr. Balione. Okay, questions, guys, aside from Mr. Balione. Is there any question?
Can I have a question, sir?
Yes, but what is your question?
Asa yung nagamit ng double ganit?
Yun. Double, again, kwanin siya, most commonly used kung floating points kasi, pwede si float o si double kung na values with decimal places or numbers with floating points yung mga kuan. For example, 1.5, 2.30. So, ang mag-hold ana, dili na siya kaya ni flow ani in. Kaya ang assigned ana na data type, may specific data type na mag-hold ana, guys. Diha pwede or diha ang capable si float o si double. Yun nga, si float, guys, may limitation siya. Sandali, hanapin ko lang yung slide na ginawa ko before or na-present ko dati. Pag sinabi nating koan, pag sinabi nating... Eto. Pag sinabi, ay, hindi pala, wala pala dito si double. Pag sinabi nating kuan, guys, pag sinabi nating float, 4 bytes, iyahang kaya. Pag sinabi nating double, 8 bytes. Again, twice the capacity of sandali, I'll try ko lang. Twice the capacity of a coil float. So, ito siya ang sa float, guys. Diba na nabigay na ito dati? And I think visible na ito sa LMS. Visible ba? Ito for int, whole numbers ang gina-hold ni int, guys. Then for numbers, we hold real numbers or numbers with decimal values or decimal play a fun siya. Ang nag-hold na si float o si double. Pero ang kay float, ang capacity niya is until 4 bytes lang. Okay? Ang kang kuhan, as you can observe, kuhan na siya, 6 decimal places lang na siya taman. Ang kang double kasi kaya niya twice the capacity of float. It means 8 bytes yung capacity ni float, ni double. Twice the capacity of float po. Kumbaga, double con ang kaya ni float pag double yung gamit natin. Okay? For in, car, ito siya. Ito yung sa array, sabi kanina, array. So, ganito yung declaration ng array. Diba? Sabi ko na yan before. And pag sinabi nating array, medyo it helps our program to minimize or makakuhaan ka ng ITN yung program. Yun pala. ITN yung program, yung third code natin. Again, we'll be having that one in the future po. Hindi naman yan natin i-escape. Okay na? Question? Joseph, may formative assessment pa tayo, Joseph?
Sir?
May formative assessment tayo na naka-prepare? Wala.
Wala, sir.
Sige po. Since tapos naman kayo ni no? Last week lang. Last week ba?
Yes, sir. Last week, sir.
Sige po. Thank you. Bale, nagka-problem lang tayo kay Mr. Joseph yung sa technicality. Parang hindi nakapasin si Joseph kasi nga may, technically may problem sa regarding the internet connection. Thank you, Joseph. A round of applause, please, for Mr. Raspinias. Yung ano lang, Joseph, parang nagiging, ang nangyari kasi kanina during the presentation, yun nga, as much as possible, avoid natin yung reading ng ating presentation. Most of the time, maybe explanation more on and very kwan lang sa kanang details lang yung lagay natin sa presentation kasi parang nangyari kasi Okay, but to sum it up, nice presentation. Very detailed po siya in terms of kanang kwan kasi yung mga may mga terms, since again, considering na nga, kanang nasa napamta sa beginners na stage. So, yung mga, for example, yung si void and so on, medyo na-discuss natin. And nine siya nga, as early as now na-discuss. Pero, kasi pag as early as now na-discuss siya, baka bale yung curiosity ng mga kuanis. And it adds additional kind of confusion. Pero hopefully, na bigyan naman siya ng na stress out naman siya kung ano yung kung kano saan natin siya kailangan inside our program. Thank you. A round of applause please for Mr. Joseph. And at this moment or juncture, we will be having the next presenter. Namely Miss Bakiran and Mr. Polio. Miss Bakiran.
Wala si Bakiran, sir.
Ah, wala si Bakiran. Para nasa Zoom siya ngayon. Oh, ano ito? Ay, gilog pala yun. Kasi nga, di ba, nagkuan? Nagsakit? Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Oo, baka ka na. So, if nag-encounter yung mga, for example, kind of illness or kind of mga palan siya, mga sipon, ubo, then again, inom siya ng tambal, guys, kasi sa panahon karon especially December na, uso na siya ang ubo, kalintura, sipon. I am one of those who are kaan ka ng sipon or ubo. Sige, Mr. Polio. Pero, okay naman, Mr. Polio, no? Prepared naman tayo for the presentation.
Yes, sir. Ako unang kay Bakiran, sir. Na, ano,
sige.
Presentation.
Ah, nag-video siya?
Ano, PowerPoint, yeah.
Ah, sige po. Thank you. You may now start your presentation, Mr. Polio. Good luck. Okay.